April 26, 1986 is a date that will live long in the memory. At 1:26 a.m., the core of reactor number 4 at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant in Ukraine exploded in the dead of night. An immense explosion blew the 2,000-ton concrete reactor cover nearly 15 meters into the air. It was the starting point for what would become the world's worst nuclear accident. It was marked by the Chernobyl cloud, a radioactive plume that crossed much of Europe. The disaster also concealed an unprecedented construction adventure, the building of the Chernobyl sarcophagus and today's immense containment structure. A radioactive epic begun just 1 month after the disaster by Soviet engineers and partly completed in 2019. In this new episode of Looking For, I take you to the heart of this unprecedented construction site to present all the challenges of the Chernobyl Arch, a megastructure unique in the world. With its 108 meter height and 257 meter span, the Chernobyl Arch is enough to enclose the Statue of Liberty, a gigantic arch whose steel structure alone weighs 25,000 tons. With such dimensions, this type of structure would inevitably have been complex to build anywhere, except that the structure, which began construction in April 2012, is located on a site surrounded by forests and swamps, a long way from the factories where the building materials are manufactured, and with winter temperatures that can drop to minus 30 degrees. But these difficulties pale in comparison with the radioactivity of the site, which will radically complicate the construction work. Surrounded by 200 technicians from 21 different countries, 1,200 Ukrainian workers have been working in the 30-kilometer exclusion zone established following the explosion. Their mission? To construct a building capable of containing the damaged reactor in a durable and, above all, leak-proof manner. In 1986, the Chernobyl region, like the rest of Ukraine, was a Soviet Socialist Republic, one of the republics of the Soviet Union, the USSR. In the months following the explosion, Soviet engineers erected an initial steel and concrete sarcophagus to serve this purpose. Just 2 months after the disaster, 90,000 workers went to work from June to November 1986 to build the Chernobyl sarcophagus. But the urgent need to act and the dangerous nature of the work resulted in an unstable, leaky structure, which over time and in adverse weather conditions deteriorated significantly, to the point of presenting a serious risk of collapse, which could lead to further dispersion of radioactive material. Concern is heightened by the fact that 90% of the 200 tons of fuel present inside the reactor at the time of the explosion are still there. In the late 1990s, consolidation work was undertaken to deal with the most urgent problems. This work was intended to provide some 15 years of respite. After gaining independence, Ukraine decided to take a long-term approach to the problem, and in 2004, launched a call for tenders to design, build, and commission a new secure containment facility. Several construction giants responded, but in the end, Novarca, a consortium specially set up by the French companies Bouygues and Vinci, won the bid with its metal arch project. The aim of this containment structure is not to stop radiation, which rapidly becomes negligible with distance, but to prevent further contamination of the environment through leakage of contaminated particles. To fulfill this barrier role, a steel structure with stainless steel inner cladding was designed. External cladding on the frame protects the damaged reactor from external aggression. However, the signing of the contract in September 2007 marked the beginning of a long series of difficulties, since working in a radioactive zone implies taking health precautions, which are just as much a technical challenge. Although radioactivities now fall into almost normal levels in most of the exclusion zone, the problem remains that large quantities of radioactive debris were buried all over the site in the months following the accident, and no precise mapping of these dumps exist. So, even before starting construction of the containment building, Novarca first had to completely clean up the area on which it planned to establish its future worksite. an area of 90,000 square meters where thousands of tons of soil, vegetation, and radioactive waste had to be excavated and replaced by sand to an average height of 1 meter. And to further limit the radiation emanating from radioactive sources likely to lie below the level of the stripping, the area was covered with concrete slabs. Another exceptional measure taken to limit workers' exposure was to set up the site not around the reactor to be covered, but 300 meters from it. This remoteness means that the workers can work without the protective equipment specific to radioactive environments. They're simply fitted with a mask in case of an incident, and two dosimeters to check their level of exposure. Only once the vessel's been built will it be transported to the reactor. This is an unprecedented challenge for Novarka's engineers, since they have to move 36,000 tons horizontally over a distance of 300 meters, a world first that will make the Chernobyl Arch the largest mobile structure on Earth. To achieve this, the giant arch rests on rails of sorts known as longrines, huge reinforced concrete beams with Teflon-coated surfaces. This material, combined with the stainless steel plates beneath the arch's feet, reduces the intense friction forces that will be exerted when the arch is pushed into its final position by hydraulic jacks. In keeping with the same concern to work as far away from the reactor as possible, the Chernobyl containment system was built in two stages. First, a first half arch was built, then placed in an intermediate zone, halfway between its construction site and the reactor, to leave the construction area available for the second half arch. As with the first, Novarka's engineers opted for a surprising procedure. It wasn't the walls that were built first, but the roof. Indeed, an arch of this size can only be stable once closed, which is why the upper part was built first. Once completed, it was lifted 30 meters using lifting towers designed to hoist loads of tens of thousands of tons. The lower elements were then added to the space left below, and the whole structure was then raised again by 30 meters. In the end, three lifting operations per half arch were required. In 2016, a system of pulleys and hoists was installed to enable what remained of the damaged reactor to be dismantled. Two overhead cranes, each with a lifting capacity of 750 tons and a length of 100 meters, are also lined up inside the structure to carry the tools and robots required for future dismantling. Once the arch had been fitted out, it was pushed over the reactor 330 meters away. This operation, which took place in November 2016, lasted almost 13 days. But the new containment system won't be fully operational until July 2019. This long waiting period can be explained by the fact that the containment was not designed solely to confine the reactor. Its purpose is also to enable the current sarcophagus and the reactor's remains to be dismantled under optimum safety conditions. Because of the radioactivity involved, these operations can only be carried out by machines and robots. In fact, the containment vessel is so large not only because of the size of the sarcophagus to be covered, but also, and above all, to accommodate these machines. To enable these operations, Novarka's constructed technical buildings. They act as access locks to the arch for personnel, equipment, and the removal of products from the damaged reactor. Secondly, they house the equipment required to operate the facility, such as ventilation and power supplies. Finally, they provide a hall for the preparation and conditioning of dismantling products prior to their evacuation to the outside world. These three functions meant that the buildings had to be located very close to the arc, where the radiation was more intense. As radiation stopped by concrete, temporary concrete walls were first built to protect the workers responsible for constructing the buildings. And to limit their exposure time, they were taught and rehearsed in a school several kilometers from the construction site. But behind this extraordinary construction site remains an unanswered question. When will dismantling take place? The only certainty is that the containment arc is guaranteed to last for 100 years. According to the experts, this is enough time to develop the technologies needed for the dismantling operation, finding the solution, but also finding the money. Even before decommissioning, the containment systems already cost almost 1.4 billion euros, almost twice as much as originally planned. Only time will tell whether this super arch will indeed be Chernobyl's final resting place. That's the end of this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel. It really helps. I'll see you soon on Looking For.